In this lecture video, we studied about the schematic diagram of diesel power plant and the elements of diesel power plant. Student, now you see the diagram. This diagram represents the schematic diagram, the another name layout of the steam diesel power plant. Now you see, this is the fuel tank component, main component, and then next that is the starting oil tank is there. This is the diesel engine, cooling tower. This is the lubricating system. This is the generator, silencer, and then surge tank. These are the main component. Okay, so the huge amount of the, what is the basic working operations of the diesel power plant? A huge amount of the fuel is stored in the fuel tank. From the fuel tank, through transfer pump, the diesel is pumped and then go to day tank. Day tank is nothing but the, for example, per day we, there is 100 liters of diesel is used as a fuel for producing the electricity, mean that 100 liters only is stored in the day tank. This is called as a day tank. Then from the day tank to again come to fuel tank, this is, if suppose more than 100 liters means the extra, that means diesel comes to fuel. That is, if overflow means that the diesel will again come back to fuel tank. This is the RMR also indicated in the schematic diagram. Then next is the starting oil tank. Starting air compressor also is used for starting purpose. And then this is the diesel engine. The diesel engine may be 4-stroke engine or 2-stroke engine. This is the lubrication for lubricating purpose. So the lubricating oil, okay. So this is the lubricating oil tank. This is the lubricating oil tank. From the lubricating oil tank, you see, from the oil pump and then goes to oil cooler, then again goes to here. That is the fuel injection only, pump only. Okay, here filter also is used. This is the cooling tower. Okay, the exhaust gas is exhausted through silencer only. This is the intake air filter. Here the cooling tower. So this is the raw water pump. So the from the raw water, that pump goes cooling tower, cooled, okay, again is goes to, that means this is the heat exchanger. Okay, so here this is the filter and purifier, which is used in the lubricating oil. Okay, so here what are the system is used? This is the fuel system. This is the air intake system, air intake system, and then here that is the exhaust system. This is the exhaust system, and then alternator, that is the alternatory system. Now we detailedly studied about the function of each system of a diesel power plant. Okay, first diesel engine. The diesel engine is used as a prime mover, which is used to produce mechanical energy. And then the diesel engine may be 2-stroke engine or 4-stroke engine. Suppose we are using the 4-stroke diesel engine, the cycle of operation completed in 4-stroke or 2 revolution. What are the 4 strokes? 4 strokes, succession stroke, compression stroke, working stroke, exhaust stroke. Suppose the two stroke engines are used as a diesel engine, the four operations are completed in the two strokes or one revolution. That is, forward stroke combining intake and compression, the backward stroke combining working and exhaust stroke only. The two stroke engine develops more power, it has got higher fuel consumption, it costs less than the four stroke engine. The four stroke engine has higher efficiency compared to two stroke engine, and then lower fuel consumption, more effective lubrication than the two stroke engine. This is the advantages of four stroke engine. The ignition process is used in the diesel power plant, which may be through the compression ignition or spark ignition. In the compression ignition, the combustion starts by spontaneous ignition of fuel and air because of high temperature developed by the compression of the air. The spark ignition engine uses a spark plug to ignite the fuel air mixer. This is the details about diesel engine. This is the one of the element of the diesel power plant. We already seen in the layout. That is the schematic diagram. The second system is the fuel system. The fuel system is mainly consist of that is the fuel tank, fuel transfer pump, purifiers, heaters, and then pipe connections. These are considered as a fuel system. The fuel received by the plant is stored in bulk storage tank. This is the fuel tank, which are situated outer for the safety. The fuel tank is situated outer only. From the fuel tank, the oil is conveyed to the engine, and the oil should be purified before it is delivered to the diesel engine in order to remove all the suspended impurities. This process is done by purifiers. That's why the purifier is used in the fuel system. The heaters are necessary since the fuel should be preheated before fed to the diesel engine. So these are the function of fuel system. Then second system is air intake system. The air is drawn from the outside the diesel engine room, that is the from the outside diesel engine room, and is delivered to the inlet through the air filters, which is used to remove the dust and other suspended impurities from the air. What type of filters is used in the air intake system is dry type, oil path type, and then ESP means the electrostatic precipitator type. In the cold climate, the intake air is heated by using a heat from the exhaust gases before injected to the diesel engine. The supercharging is usually employed to increase the pressure of the intake air above the atmospheric pressure. That means pressure. The atmospheric pressure normally 35 degree centigrade or 45 degree centigrade. So if you want to increase the pressure above than the atmospheric pressure, you have to use the supercharger in the air intake system. This is the second system of that is the elements of a diesel power plant. The third system is engine cooling system. The engine cooling system, what are the components included in the system? Coolant pump, spray pond or cooling tower, water treatment, filtration plant. the enormous amount of the heat developed inside the cylinder of the diesel engine due to the burning of the fuel, the temperature inside the diesel engine would be very high. If in order to reduce the temperature, an efficient cooling must be provided. That's why the cooling system is used in the diesel power plant. The cold water obtained from the outside source, which is purified, and then water is passed through the diesel engine, then it absorbs much of the heat. In this process, it becomes quite hot. The hot water is either discharged suitably or cooled and used again as a circulating cold water. For cooling hot water, spray pond or cooling tower is used. So this is the function of engine cooling system in a diesel power plant. Then engine lubricating system. The main purpose of lubrication is to reduce the friction of the moving parts of the diesel engine and also to minimize the wear and tear of moving parts of the diesel engine. For that purpose only we are using the lubricating oil in the diesel power plant. This lubricating system comprises of the lubricating oil pump, oil tank, filters, purifiers, coolers, connecting pipes. The diesel engine parts which require lubrication are cylinders, piston, gears, crankshaft, connecting rod and bearings. The piston and the cylinder need special lubricating oil. The forced feed lubrication is mostly used, and the equipment for this purpose includes pumps, oil cooler, oil cleaner, sump oil tank, etc. So these are the forced feed lubrication system. Okay, so these are the working functions of the engine lubricating system. Then we studied about the exhaust cooling system. The exhaust system, the function of exhaust system, the function of exhaust system is to discharge the engine exhaust to the atmosphere. A good exhaust system should keep the noise at low level, the exhaust well above the ground level to reduce the air pollution. That system only is called as the good exhaust system in the steam power plant. When the mixture of fuel and air burns inside the diesel engine, hot gases are produced. These hot gases needed to be expelled because the fresh charge may be introduced into the engine. The exhaust gases are conveyed through silencer and connecting ducts. That's why the silencer is used in the diesel power plant. The function of the silencer is to reduce the noise level of the exhaust gases as they pass through the exhaust pipe. So this is the function of the exhaust system in diesel power plant. Then engine starting system. The engine starting system comprises of storage battery, air compressor, self-starter, etc. This system provided to rotate the engine initially while starting the engine until the firing starts and the unit runs under its own power. So this is similar to thyristor. If first initially if you want to trigger the thyristor, we can give the gate pulse to the gate. Once the thyristor is triggered, if you can remove the pulse from the gate also, the thyristor is turned on. The same principle here, you can the diesel engine first initially is started through starting systems. Once it's started, until the firing starts, the unit runs under its own power only. For small size of diesel engine, hand cranking is adopted for adequate, or that means the battery driven motors may be employed. For large diesel engine, size diesel engine, generator sets, compressor, air starting is employed. In the compressed air system of starting, the compressed air from the tank at a high pressure is admitted to a few of engine cylinders, making them to act as reciprocating air motors to turn the engine shaft. The fuel is admitted to the remaining cylinder, which causes the engine to start under its own power. This is the function of engine starting system in diesel power plant. Then diesel engine alternator. Diesel engine alternator, that is alternators. Alternators coupled to the diesel engine mechanically, which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. The alternator is the salient pole type construction, and then the speed is 214, that is 214 to 1000 RPM. The capacity is 25 to 5000 kVA at 0.8 power factor lagging. This is the specification of alternators. The output voltage of the alternators are 440 volt because 3 phase. Suppose in case of small machines, okay, the voltage 2220 volt, that is the 440 volt in case of small machines for 3 phase supply. Suppose for large machine, the output voltage is 2220 volt, okay. The alternators are directly coupled to the diesel engine, that is mechanically coupled, electrically isolated. The diesel engines are provided with automatic voltage regulators to regulate the voltage, that is to permit closed voltage regulation and satisfactory parallel operation. That purpose we are using the automatic voltage regulator in the diesel power plant. The diesel engines are provided with damper windings. Okay, so to damper winding is used to reduce the hunding for during starting the hunding produced. So to reduce the hunding, the damper winding is used. The last one is, what are the meters used in the diesel power plant? That is called as a instrumentation system. In the instrumentations, number of instruments used, why? To ensure satisfactory operation. First one is thermometers. The thermometer is used for the measurement of exhaust temperature, lubricating oil temperature, fuel oil temperature, injection air compressor temperature. For this purpose only we are using the thermometers used in the diesel power plant. The next we are using the pressure cages. The pressure cages is used to gauge both final and interstage pressure of the starting air system, lubricating oil system, before and after cooler, cooling tower, fuel oil before and after strainer. This is the function of the pressure cage. Then synchronizing equipment is used to synchronize purpose. Then wattmeters, voltmeters, ammeters is used for measuring power, voltage and ammeter current respectively. Then visible and audible alarms is used in the diesel power plant, which is used to give warning in the event of high lubricating oil temperature, low lubricating oil temperature, incorrect starting, blower motor overcurrent. So far these are the causes happened in the diesel power plant. The visible and audible alarm is used to give warning to the operators in the control room. Dear student, in the diesel power plant, what are the system used in the diesel power plant? So fuel system, air intake system, and then lubricating system, cooling system, exhaust system, starting system, alternator, and then instrumentation. So the overall diesel power plant is divided into these 7 systems. Okay, the all the component which are placed in the layout comes under within these 7 system only. So dear student, under this topic, how the question will come in the VTU examination, with the needs get explain the diesel power plant, you can draw the diagram. Otherwise, explain the elements of diesel power plant in detail. Okay, so minimum 8 mark, maximum 10 mark questions. Thank you students for watching this video.